Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at how to use multiple languages in Pages so spell checking works correctly. Okay, so say you're writing something in Pages and you have a passage in there that's in a different language. Well, you're going to get all these red underline marks and flags in spell check because all the words seem to be spelled wrong. But you can set Pages so that it understands that portion is in a different language. So here I have a simple document open in Pages. And you can see I start off with a quote that's in French. And it has all of these red underline marks here because the spell checker has been triggered. And you can see the quote's then repeated in English and it's fine. Now what I'd like to be able to do is tell Pages that this is in French and to spell check it in French rather than in English. So I'm going to start off by highlighting, by selecting this section here that's in French. Then I'm going to bring up the inspector. Now in the inspector, the section I want to go to is the text part. And under text, I want to go to more. And here you'll see a listing for language. And I can change the language for the selected area. So I'm going to change this to French. And you can see now it understands that this section is in French. If I were to click over here to this section, you can see it understands that's in English. Click back in here, it knows that's in French. Now here's an interesting other setting you can use. You can select a portion or the entire thing, select all, and I can change the language to all. And now it will spell check taking into account all words in all different languages. So it's good if you're constantly switching between languages. Likewise, you could also select none. So let's go back here and just show it again and all in American English. And let's say I just don't want to even deal with spell checking in this section. I can say none. And now spell checking is essentially turned off for this section in here. That could be useful if the language isn't listed. Or perhaps you've got some placeholder text in there that's a bunch of gibberish, or you've put something in there with lots of different names or things like that. You can set the language to none for that section. And you can see the other section here when I click on it is set to English. This section that's set to none. So I hope you found this tip useful, and if you use Pages you may want to pick up my book called My Pages. And you can get this in bookstores and online sites around the world, and it has lots of useful tips like this one, which is on page 221. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.